have to study abroad? MeetUniversity.com is here to help. Our technology will help you choose the best university, find relevant information, help you prepare a successful application, and put you in direct touch with the admission officers.
Good evening, everyone. I, Anushka Chauhan.
And I, Kulsum Namazi.
Welcome you this fine evening for our extempore speaking competition, Impromptu, under the banner of our college fest, Yuvaflare. Before we begin, I would like to thank our management, Dr. Sister Sandra Horta, our vice principal, Dr. Sister Shirley, our correspondent, Sister Glory, and our Dean of Academics, Dr. Malika Shetty Ma'am, for giving us this opportunity to conduct this one-of-a-kind event.
On that note, I would request Seher to lead us into prayer.
Let us all join our hands and close our eyes in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you today asking for your guidance, wisdom, and support as we begin the meeting. We ask that you will strengthen us, restore us, and inspire us with your love. We ask that you bless the students and the faculty that make our college a great place. We pray that you will guide us in all ways so that we seek your will in everything that we do. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Let us all pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Amen. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome.
Thank you, Sahar. With the rising environmental issue and climate change, I think it's imperative that we young adults of society bring about change. Rightly said by Wendell Berry, what I stand for is what I stand on, and I believe that every change arises from open dialogue. With that being said, we would like to introduce our judges to the gathering.
Mr. Pradeep Yara, sir, works as an outreach coordinator at Eat Kind India campaign in the Farm Animal Protection Department at the Humane Society India. It is a chapter, Indian chapter of Humane Society International, which is the world's most effective animal protection organization, defending all animals for more than 25 years, working around the globe to promote the human-animal bond and confronting the cruelty to animals in all its forms. Welcome, sir. We are delighted to have you here with us today. Our second judge for the day is Ms. Dhanalakshmi Ma'am, HOD and Assistant Professor in the Department of Environmental Studies and our Prakriti Club Coordinator at St. Francis College for Women. Thank you so much for joining us, ma'am. I would also like to take a moment to introduce you all to our sponsors. Meet University is a consultant agency which helps you choose best universities. So do check out their website. And Mr. Pranay Rai Raj, who has sponsored us in the memory of his late father, Mr. Jangaya, along with Mr. Rakesh Tiwari and Bharat Petroleum. May God bless Mr. Jangaya's soul. Before we begin, I would like to remind all the contestants of the rule. A topic related to environmental issues would be given on spot, and the participant would be given 2 minutes to think and then proceed to talk for 2 minutes.
We begin with our first contestant for the evening, Aisha.
Good evening, everyone. This is Aisha from second year BSc ANBC. So today my topic is talking about the role of farm animal welfare in the sustainable systems. The first thing that I would like to speak about, what is the exact idea of sustainability? So sustainability means meeting our own needs without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Now, why is it very important for us to support animal welfare? Because there are thousands of animals that are being misused and used in the field of entertainment, food, and they are actually suffering. Now, why is animal welfare a problem is because there are abuses that good livestock producers would not tolerate, that they are animal cruel. Now, they are animal cruelty abuses such as dragging down the crippled cattle, rough handling them, throwing the baby dairy calves, failing to provide shelter, or shackling and hoisting an animal prior to ritual slaughter. So, I feel that the farm animals should be not ill-treated or misused for the sake of human welfare. Thank you.
The next contestant would be Trisha.
Yes, Kulsum, I'm here.
Yeah, could I please request you to turn on your camera? Thank you.
Yes, can I start?
Yes, Trisha, before you start, a small announcement for all the contestants. Please clearly list out your topic before you start speaking so it's clear for everyone else, because it's been sent to you via WhatsApp. Please begin, Trisha, your time will start now.
Good afternoon, everybody. The topic that I've been given is intensive animal agriculture could spare the pandemic. Well, the one thing we all have in common is our Mother Earth, who gives birth, nurtures, protects, and sacrifices us. But currently at this time, our Mother Earth is crying. And you may ask why? It's because of the pandemic that we have at our hands right now. Well, one of the reasons behind this is the deforestation, is the forest fires, and most importantly, our cruel behavior towards animals. You may ask, how is this possible? Well, that's because when we don't protect our animals, we are in fact causing harm to the entire food chain, to the entire cycle. And when certain loopholes arise in that food chain, in that cycle, it affects the other elements as well. It affects human beings as well. And that's the reason why the pandemic is spreading as much as forest fires in the earth. So what we all can do is we all can live an eco-friendly life. We can try and reduce the non-vegetarian consumption. We all can plant trees. We all can activate against deforestation. And most importantly, in our own lives, we can come up with posters, videos, and interactive events and competitions like these that create awareness about saving the earth, about how animal agriculture is so very important. It is a neglected term. It is a neglected cause. But we need to create awareness about this. And it's not just the farmers or the rural areas that could do something about it, but we, as the college students also, could create awareness, could take small but meaningful steps towards intensive agriculture, towards intensive animal agriculture. Thank you.
Thank you, Trisha. That was very nice. Just in time, I must say. Our next contestant for the evening would be Varsha. Dinaram Varsha, are you here? Hi,
could yes, I please yes, hi. So am I giving you 2 minutes time? Or
because
am I
your topic
right
was
now?
Sent 2 minutes ago when Trisha started talking, I requested you to turn on your camera and please begin.
The topic that has been assigned to me is animal welfare and its holistic approach. So what exactly the term holistic means? It basically means that, the traditional care that is usually given to a particular thing, right? So when I have to talk in particular to that of an animal, so pets are something that all of us are I wouldn't just generalize to all of us, but at least to an extent, most of us are, in love with pets, and, it's somewhere makes us feel that sense of belonging to it. So it somehow it's really very important for us in the same time where we see to it that our pets are like super healthy. And in order to look after it, there's something called as an holistic approach that is usually preferable to practice it helps the pet to be more healthier. And how can we do that is, by regular conduct of different lab tests and seeing to it that, they are given proper nutritious food and maybe something like that. Thank you.
Thank you, Varsha. That was very nice. May I request the next contestants, Dhanya? Dhanya, are you here in the meet?
Dhanya, you're on mute.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Dhanya Tejaswi, and my topic today is effects of animal agriculture on indigenous people and livestock. So animal agriculture obviously means that we take the animals and we use them as food material. So when the animal slaughter is done in an unsustainable way, what happens is it affects the ecosystem, and therefore it also impacts the indigenous people. Industry and other forms of unsustainable livestock production have very real impacts on forests, climate and the environment. They also have devastating consequences for communities and indigenous people, peasants and women. According to United Nations Food and Agriculture, there have been so many ecosystems around the world that have been destroyed just because of unsustainable animal husbandry and animal agriculture. For example, when we take too much of honey out of the environment, a lot of honeybees die, and due to which pollination and other important processes get paused in between, because of which a lot of agriculture does not also happen. So it is very important to be careful with our animal husbandry and animal agriculture. Thank you.
Thank you, Dhanya. Very well spoken. I'd like to call up our next contestant. Sugandhini. P. Sugandhini Reddy, are you here?
Yeah, I hope I'm audible and visible.
Yes, you are. All the best.
So, namaste everyone. This is P. Sugandhini Reddy. The topic given to me is sacred groves and indigenous people. So, sacred groves are those which are a part of the forest, and they are left untouched by the tribal people or forest people living there. And mostly medicinal plants are grown in those areas. And so these were planted by the tribals only, but they don't take proper care of those things. They are just left to one side. So as we know that medicinal plants are of much value to us in any field. So we should start like growing more of sacred groves like that. And indigenous people are the first people or the tribals or the natives of any place. So the sacred groves and the indigenous people have a connection, because the indigenous people have planted them, but they are left aside and not much cared about. But I feel that it is our responsibility to think about those plants as well, because as I mentioned before, they help us in many ways. We know that medicinal plants like tulsi, neem are good for our health. They help in curing many diseases. So I think that we should like start developing more and more of sacred groves wherever possible. Thank you.
Thank you. That was very informative. Calling up the next contestant, Deepshika. You can begin. All the best.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. My name is Deepshika, and the topic given to me is facing public health problems with plant-based medicines. So firstly, and due to this pandemic, everybody has started taking care of their health more than even before. So studies include that plant-based medicines, which we used to consume from our ancient time, will improve our health 25% more than the allopathy or any other drugs. So even 25% of the drugs today we are using are plant-based mechanism, and they help us in long term than the other medicines. So plant-based, we can also improve our health with plant-based food. So for example, the first widespread of smallpox was indeed cured with the leaves, plant leaves, indigenous plant leaves, which were present in many places, even India. India is also known as ancient plant-based medical treatment place. And we also have many foods which can cure many big diseases. We have oils which can cure many big health problems, even diabetes and problems related to our muscles. So I think it's a good opportunity for us in this pandemic. We got that to learn more about plant-based foods. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you. That was extremely illuminating. Calling up the next contestant, Sheikh Israt Umisa.
Good evening, everyone. I hope I'm audible and visible.
Yes, you are. All the best. Please begin.
Yeah. Yes. Good evening, everyone present here. This is Ishrat from Begum 3H, and the topic given to me is the topic given to me is reducing greenhouse gas emissions through food choices. So the greenhouse gases effect is more in the environment. How it is, the heat is trapped and it warms our globe. So that is one of the main causes of global warming. Previously in India, people were used to eat rice, wheat, barley, and that was a staple food in the north part or south part or the eastern and western part of India. But now, if we ask people, if we give them, like, you're given all the opportunities and you have the basic amenities provided to you, and which one do you choose? So the people are switching their food opinions to fruits, vegetables, and you are also trying to become vegans. Vegans are nothing but people who don't even use milk products. So milk was a basic food previously in India, but now people are trying to switch from milk products also. So for emitting and reducing greenhouse gases, the switching to protein-based food, eating vegetables and plant-based foods, and the nutrition tips are also very much spread out to reduce the carbon footprint. Many people feel an urgent reduce to their impact on Earth because of the catastrophic effects of climate change and resource extraction. So one of the strategy to lower our carbon footprint is to measure our total greenhouse gas and emissions and driving from vehicles or using electricity. But the simple ways to stop this is we should stop wasting food, ditch the plastic, eat less meat, and try plant-based protein, which now many people are coming to. So these are the few ways which they can do. Thank you.
Thank you. That was very educational. Calling up our next contestant, Janvi Singh.
Yes, I hope I'm audible and visible.
Yes, you are. All the best. Please begin.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Janvi. I'm from BA SLP first year. So my topic is a ban on single-use plastic. So single-use plastic are that plastic which cannot be disposed and which cannot be used again. So it plastic is like we are really habituated to the plastic. Like if it, actually the plastic is banned in India and all over the world, but still we use plastic, and because it is easily available and like it's really cheap. So I think every small change can happen from our home. Like if we individually take any step, we can bring a change. Plastics, everyone knows that plastic harms, and it how it affects environment and how it like it is really harmful, and it cannot be disposed like thousands of years. And we are a part of a like if we are a part of a community in which we should take steps together. We can use 4R principle, like reduce, reuse, recover, and recycle plastic. And instead of that, we can use jute bags. We can shift on that. But I guess like if we all take steps collectively, then only we can achieve the goal if we decide. And I think government should imply strict rules and regulations so that the ban on plastic can be reduced, ban on plastic can be actually implemented, and we can shift to eco-friendly products like jute bags, and we can help to save environment. Thank you.
Thank you, Janvi. You are good. Our next contestant would be Khushi Jain, and her topic would be mitigation climate crisis through sustainable food systems. Khushi?
Hello everyone, this is me Khushi Jain from Hello everyone, this is me Khushi Jain from BAPP. I'm from St. Francis College for Women. The topic which I have been given today is mitigation of climate crisis to sustainable food system. What is mitigation? Mitigation is reduction. Reduction in the climate crisis. The climate crisis which we are facing today have no bounds very high rainfall to very high temperature to very low temperature. We have been seeing this all in these one to two years. So how can we reduce these climate crisis through our change in a food system? According to me, the food connects everything. If we take proper food, for example, switching to vegan, which have been in very much trend these days, will help in a proper climate in the environment. For example, if we switch for vegan and reduce taking non-vegetarian food which harm our environment, for example, some crops, vegetables are such that they protect our environment, but when we take them for our consumption, when we take them our food, their concentration in the environment, in our agriculture, decreases, and it will lead to many problems. Thank you.
Thank you, Khushi. Very well spoken. Our next contestant would be Anu Sanjana, and her topic would be impact of animal agriculture on water bodies.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you're audible, Sanjana. All the best.
Yeah, hello everyone. I'm Anu Sanjana, and my topic is impact of animal agriculture on water bodies. And grazing animals in pasture production can affect water quality both positively and negatively. Good management and practices of forage production protect the soil surface from erosion compared with conventionally produced crops. And grazing animals in pasture production can negatively affect water through erosion and sediment transport into surface waters. Through nutrients from urine and feces dropped by the animals and fertility practices associated with the production of high quality pasture, and through pathogens from waste and erosion sediments transport is primarily associated with high density stocking and or poor forage stands. The two nutrients of primary concern relating to animal production are nitrogen, and nitrogen is of concern because of high concentrations in drinking water from cows, whereas other forms of N are concerned to be potentially carcinogenic and form of concern because it causes eutrophication of surface water bodies. Thank you.
That was very well refined. The next contestant for the evening would be Mariam Farida, and her topic would be eat kind and be kind.
Yes, Kusum, am I audible?
Yes, you're audible. All the best.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. I am Mariam, and my topic is about eat kind and be kind. I think this generally means that, you know, foremost, like, be kind to animals because they provide us with a lot of facilities, giving us a lot of nutritive values, etc. Eating kind animals as in, like, not harming them. We are using them, I mean, we are taking them for ourselves. That means, like, being good to them, not that we are slaughtering them very badly and consuming them. That is something I feel wrong. And also being kind to animals may also include giving them proper nurturing, caring them properly, because at the end we're going to be, you know, using them. I'm really out of words, I'm sorry, but yeah, being kind to animals, and yeah, that's all I can talk. Thank you, Kulsum.
Thank you, Mariam. That was extremely expressive. It's all good. Okay, we'd move on to our next contestant. Rakshita, are you here?
Good evening, everyone. This is Rakshita Mart from BSc first year BTMBC. And my topic is One Health Paradigm Approach, Human and Planetary Health. The meaning of my topic is that is planetary health refers to the health of human civilization and the state of natural systems on which it depends. So basically, planetary health offers a way to
understand. Rakshita, I'm so sorry to interrupt you. We can't see you, Rakshita. Could you please turn on your camera?
Sorry, there is some problem with my camera.
I'm so sorry, Rakshita. This is an extemporic. Can you try? Just give it a try once more and then we can go ahead.
Okay, so if you don't mind, can you go to the next contestant? I'll try by the time.
Unfortunately, you would be gracefully ending our event. You're the last one.
Yes. Good evening, everyone. My name is Rakshita Amar from BSc first year BTMBC. And my topic is One Health Paradigm Approach, Human and Planetary Health. So my topic, the meaning of my topic is nothing but I'll try to explain it in simple words. That is how the nature, that is the environment and the civilization is interdependent on each other. That is, as we all know that, for example, as we take the food chain, so basically the food, like the animals and the nature is interdependent for the living or the way of life for each other. In the same way, the civilization and also the nature is
Rakshita will not be joining us. She's having some technical issues, so we can move on. So I would like to tell all the participants that this was a truly scholastically invigorating experience. I really appreciate all the contestants for joining us. Now, I would request Mr. Pradeep Yara sir to please address the gathering. Sir?
Yes. Am I audible? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone. It was a very good interactive session program. And indeed, every participant have presented their views very well. And so as an aspiring and young, both conservation and also environmental wise, we all need to have to protect our nature. As per the Honorable Indian Constitution, we can say that Article 51A, subclause G, which talks about it shall be the fundamental duty of every citizen of our India to protect our lakes, rivers, and to have a compassion towards all living creatures. So, but sadly, in reality, you are saying that, so the climate change, also environmental effects, and also we are seeing that if you talk about climate change, it's a tip of a clock, and we are seeing a lot of climate change in terms of melting of ice caps, and also you see the city of Hyderabad. Forget about India, rest of India. If you can see the city of Hyderabad, which has been flooding for almost 1 week, more than 1 week. All the low lying areas have been affected. So most of them who are the primary reason for climate change, the human activities are causing a great deal of damage. So one among the aspect, a lot of the participants has presented their perspective about industrial animal agriculture. Yes, intensive animal agriculture is one of the serious threat to both environment, deforestation, and also climate change. And also as per the CDC, you can see the Center for Disease Control. So 60% of new emerging infections all are zoonotic origin. So that spreads from animals to humans, humans to animals to humans. Sorry. So because of the intensive animal agriculture practices, so a lot of the time when we see about the condition of the animals, so I don't remember the participant name, but she has specifically mentioned about the entertainment and how the animals have been treated. So rightly she has pointed out, most of the time if you see the industrial and animal agriculture, a lot of the times debeaking is being done for the hens, especially chickens, So male chickens have been that they have been using very harsh method. So the beaks have been trimmed off and they have been thrown into the boiling water. It's one of the inhuman aspect which has been taking place in the animal agriculture industry. So how can we change it is we as a conscious individual, and you are all studying the environmental science. That means you are all choosing for the sustainable options, human consumption patterns. By reducing the consumption of meat and dairy products once in a week, so we can make a significant difference in the life of the animals. At the same time, we can reduce our ecological footprint when we talk about the in terms of emissions point of view. So I think Trisha has mentioned the emissions point of view. So animal agriculture accounts closely about 14.5% to 16.5% global greenhouse gas emissions, which is comparatively high in terms of the transport sector. So by 2050, the production will be increased more than 50%. And we are all seeing the pandemic situation last year. If you can see that 2022 till 21, there is a national health burden in India. Unless until when a new emerging diseases has been, like, for example, if you take about this swine flu, it is also a zoonotic disease. So we got the vaccine. Vaccine is a temporary solution. Unless until we change the food choices and unless until we choose a sustainable and humane consumption method and also sustainable production methods and better animal welfare practices, so that could definitely change the lives of animals. At the same time, it can protect our environment. And there is a one term which has, I think, in the discussion also, one health strategy. So it's one health, which is called as, that means we shared an ecosystem. In the entire ecosystem, both animals, humans, and environment. So they are all interconnected. So we call this approach as a one health strategy. This has been devised by the WHO, World Health Organization. And a lot of sessions and also a lot of dialogues has been conducted. And even WHO and FAO, Food and Animal Organization, and also a lot of other NGOs and civil society organizations, they have conducting a lot of food sustainable systems. They have noticed that the current sustainable food systems are unsustainable, and which is causing a lot of tremendous pain to both the environment wise. And if you can see the hunger index, if you have recently gone through the global hunger index report also, India was about 101 rank. So we have deep, because we as an India has an agrarian country. So a lot of the times we have enough food crops and we have the fertile lands, but still we are not able to feed the growing population. So most of the time food has been fed to livestock in the terms of soya and corn, and resulting a lot of ecological imbalance, because 30% of arable land has been cleared off. So in the 30% of the arable land, which has a forest area. So we all know that forests promote a lot of biodiversity, and it is home to various indigenous people. So their livelihood is also being affected. So taking into this consideration, as an young and aspiring youth, you have the power to change. And also, as rightly said by the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi once said that the earth, the land, the water are not our inheritance. They are acquired from our forefathers. And we should have to pass on to the next generation as it is. We don't want the next generation to suffer from pandemics. We don't want the next generation to wear a mask wherever we go. We are not comfortable communicating with anyone. So every step, every choices we made at our dinner table will not only affect the lives of animals, at the same time, it affects both the human health and also environment. So I hope you continue the same momentum. Wish to conduct more and more outreach programs with your college. Thanks to Professor Dhanalakshmi ma'am for encouraging you all and conducting such enriching activities. So, yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. That was truly inspiring. But let me tell you something else about Pradeep, sir. He actually holds a bachelor's degree in engineering and technology and communication. And he had a very good corporate job but his passion for nature and animals made him leave it and pursue this career. So, sir, you are truly inspiring. Thank you so much for being there with us.
Thank you.
Next up, I would thank you, sir. Yeah. Next up, I would like to introduce you all. Well, she does not need any introduction, but I will request Dhanalakshmi ma'am to kindly address the gathering.
So, good evening, everyone. I'm very happy to meet you all, young minds. Yes, you just inspired us. It's not we inspired you. You just inspired us. That I can see. Yes, sir. Good evening, dear sir. Very good input that you have given related to this issues that are happening during this pandemic specifically. Yes, so great expertise. We are very happy to meet you in this auspicious evening. Okay, so now I wish to congratulate all the participants, whoever I can see over here. They were just awesome in their expression. The way they just prepared related to each and every topic that they got within 2 minutes, they just tried to express like anything with good ability of the knowledge, expression, and communication skills. Everything just added a different color to this. Yes or no? It was really awesome to meet you all today, and I'm very happy. I would like to thank our management who actually provided this platform to get an opportunity so that we can meet you young people, so that we can hear you, how sensitive you are all related to this particular environmental issues of different that we are experiencing. Yes or no, my dear young minds, you just told that related to different aspects, whether it is the term for indigenous people that you can see in rural areas, which can be considered as tribal areas, where actually they are struggling a lot related to all the aspects that we are in the requirement. Can it be honey from the beehive? Can it be awesome medicines that you can get from the Ayurvedic plants of different? Can it be of different sort of things that we are getting, and we are actually trying to get the blessing, honor of that particular? It is only because of the indigenous people that are actually struggling for that particular thing. And you just expressed related to the particular thing. I was very happy to hear you. Single-use plastic. Yes, my dear students, my dear participants over here from different institutions, I am very blessed to hear you that, yes, we need to ban the single-use plastic. But are we really doing it, my dear? Please try to have a question to you. See, simply putting a meetings and trying to give a debate on this or speaking about something, it will not matter. It will not matter, like sir said. We have to try to continue with that particular attitude and aptitude which can be applied in our daily life. See, can start with simple thing where you just go to a food juice shop where you will try to order some watermelon juice. You will get it in a plastic cup. Did you ever like to stop it? Please, Baya, don't give it to me. Don't give it to me. Stop that. Please try to inculcate the habit of try to offer some eco-friendly cups. Did we ever try to say like that? You have to maintain that courage so that you can bring awareness among the people to start with the things that we are actually talking about. So there should be an initiation. It is there, but there should be a continuity in that. So continuity in that particular thing will matters a lot so that you can see the change in the world related to environmental issues of different, and you people, the young minds, really can be considered as eco-freaks. You will be doing it, my dear. You can restore the environment like anything I'm telling you, if you just try to take a step. Don't speak, don't stop it. Try to speak upon, try to bring awareness among the public and try to follow it first. That's very important. Okay, my dear. Sir just told that the Gandhi's quote. That's wonderful quote. Actually, the world is UNESCO, VNO, UNEP, whatever the organization that is meant for the environmental challenges of different, they are actually striving for the cause where they are in the expectation of the change. The change will start from your pretty single step of your young mind, that I can see. You only can start. You only can bring the changes. You only can do it. That's where I will always refer to call you eco-freaks. Yes or no? Do you agree with that word? Do you ever question yourself that, yes, ma'am, you are calling us an eco-freak. Yes, we are real eco-freaks. We'll be following that. We will try to maintain the sustainability in and around. That is actually needed, as sir said, related by quoting the Gandhiji's, Mahatma Gandhiji's quote. Yes or no, my dear? Yes. So we need to maintain the sustainability where you can think about something. Whatever the resources, we Indians are really blessed with many natural resources that no nation in the world does. Yes or no? Do you agree or not? But thing is, but our economic status, if you see, what is the status of our economy? It's actually developing states. Why our India is not considered as developed one? You have to think about it. You are the young minds need to think about that and try to struggle for it and try to have a chances to have a utilization of all the natural resources properly so that you can maintain the sustainability where you need to leave something to your future generation. They have to be blessed. We were blessed from our previous generations. Yes or no? We are actually enjoying with those resources, whatever we acquire from our future previous generations. But now we have to think about this thing. We need to think about our future generations. That's where this world is happening like anything in the world. Sustainability. We have almost 30-year-old goals. 70 goals, sustainability developmental goals, 17 are there. And we are trying to reach those goals. We are trying to achieve these goals by the year of 2013. Is it possible? Is it possible? Question. We need to question ourselves. So it's not government, it's not somebody else can do the change, can make the change if it is the turn for the restoration of the environment, protection of the animals, protection of the particular things, whatever we are in the requirement, conservation of the resources, renewable energy uses, whatever it is, my dear youngsters, please make a note. Change will start from your single step, the pretty crude step that you can make. That's it. So actually, this is actually the very much needed thing that we need to think about this. Okay, so try to maintain that environmental eco-freak wala attitude so that you will be considered as an environmentalist so that you can bring a change in this world at any area that all is in the need of yours. Okay, my dear? So this is what I would like to share with you people. Yes, as I can see, the young minds from different institutes and different places. And our expert, sir, is here. He's very awesome in his field. He is actually struggling a lot. I can see the status of sir every day. I'll be trying to inspire from sir. He is doing something. He is actually really doing something for the cause. In the environmental aspects of different, and animal husbandry aspects of different, whatever that you just try to provoke related to that particular things. Okay, so I'm very happy, sir, and I'm very happy with you all participants. Very good. You are just awesome. Think that you are all achieved already because the participation itself is an achievement. Participation itself is an achievement. Okay, my dear, congratulations once again to you all, my dear.
I would request Pradeep Yara, sir, to please declare the results.
Yeah, sure. So, like in any game, there is no winning and there is no losing. So, we have to declare the top three participants. So, rest of the participants, you have done your best, everyone. So the first part winner is Kushi Jain, and her topic is about mitigation climate crisis through sustainable food systems. So, Kushi, you have well articulated about the, whatever the perspective you have mentioned about the topic. So, congratulations.
Thank you so much, sir. I literally didn't expect this. Thank you.
So, moving on to the next participant, Trisha. Intensive animal agriculture could spark the future pandemics. Congratulations. And third participant is Janvi Singhi. So, ban of single use of plastic.
Thank you, sir. I also didn't expect. Thank you.
Yeah. So, Most welcome. Congratulations to all the winners, and also congratulations to all the participants who has participated in the debate competition. You have presented your whatever ideas and perspectives, and remember, this is just a competition. It is not a winning or a losing. There is no.
Yes, that's true, sir. That's true.
Yeah, thanks a lot for the presenting your all.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am, for evaluating our talented young echo freaks, I must say. Moving forward, I would like to propose the vote of thanks. We, the team, would like to thank our beloved principal, Dr. Sister Sandra Horta, for her constant trust and support. We would like to thank the Yuvaflare event coordinator, Dr. Reena Diwan, ma'am, assistant coordinator, Ms. Nikita Sharma, ma'am, and all the co-coordinators for their guidance throughout our EcoFreak journey. We would like to thank Mr. Pradeep Yara, sir, for lending us his expertise and evaluating our talented youngsters. We would like to thank our club coordinator, Ms. Dhanalakshmi, ma'am, for her love and guidance. We would also like to thank our truly generous sponsors, Bharat Petroleum Gachibowli and Meet University. We would like to thank our technicians and our organizing committee for their support throughout this event. We would also like to thank our participants for making this event a huge, huge, huge success. But last but not the least, we would also like to thank all our viewers who will be gracing us with their presence in a few days. Thank you.
Looking at to study abroad? MeetUniversity.com is here to help. Our technology will help you choose the best university, find relevant information, help you prepare a successful application, and put you in direct touch with the admission officers.
Everyone, I Anushka Chauhan
and I Kusum Namazi
welcome you this fine afternoon for YuvEcofreak Award competition under the banner Yuvaflare, the campus fest year 2021-2022.
As you know that the earth is what we all have in common, and we the green team believe in what Anne Marie rightly said. We don't need a handful of people doing zero waste perfectly. We need millions of people doing it imperfectly.
Our motto for conducting this event is to showcase our young, eco-friendly minds, their ideas, and their sensitivity towards environmental issues, which is much needed to protect our Earth. The world is in the need of real-time eco-freaks who can really strive for this cause.
Our college always encourages green activity in the campus, and we students are given opportunities to come up with our creative and scientific thoughts which will be useful to restore the environment. Our panel of judges for this event are Ms. Dhanalakshmi, HOD, Assistant Professor of EVS, St. Francis College for Women, Dr. Sai Bhavani, Assistant Professor, Nizam College.
Dr. Sai Bhavani is a born environmentalist. She loves teaching and loves nature. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your time and dedication, which made it possible for us to reward the students accurately for their creative efforts.
Through this event, participants prepared eco-friendly products, posters, eco-friendly files, and models. The participants were asked to upload pictures or procedural video clips in Google Classrooms. We have compiled videos and images of some of the best entries we received, and we present it to you with immense pride.
Thank you.
Plastic waste makes its way from our home and workplaces to water bodies and landfills, which results in water and soil contamination. We use so much of plastic that no biodiversity in this world is left plastic-free today. So I, Bibi Hafsa from BZC, tried to create an eco-friendly product which is made up of used plastic wrappers and packets. So let's see how it's made. For this, we need some plastic waste plastic wrappers and newspapers. Cut them measuring 18 cm length and 8 cm breadth. Come, let's start. Eco-friendly product made by used plastic wrappers and packets. I hope you like it. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am. Continuing on with more eco-friendly projects, today I'm sharing an eco-friendly dish scrubber which we can make in very less time. I don't know if I ever thought I would own a kitchen scrubber that is cute enough to take a picture of, but guess what? I do, and today I'm sharing how you can make your own. And did I mention it's also made from just one supply, and that supply material is natural, sustainable, biodegradable, compostable and super affordable. This coconut fiber is a coarse brown material obtained from the husk of a coconut, raw, rough, bristle, yet pliant. It is resilient and eco-friendly at the same time. Using it means directly taking from the natural environment without harming it and making use of that which is residual too. Thus encouraging the idea of zero waste, biodegradable and compostable, coconut fiber is a versatile, sustainable and traditional alternative in the fight of against pollution and climate change. This scrub pad is made from 100% coconut fibers bound together with non-toxic natural adhesive, lightweight and odorless. It has great water holding capacity while still maintaining the excellent drainage and aeration, and is therefore an efficient and alternative as it is economical. It is an effective scrub for any type of vessels or surfaces. It is also a safe option when one considers the silvers of toxic material that commonly linger on vessels when using our metal synthetic variants. So I would suggest coconut scrub is the best compared to that plastic and silver toxic. Coconut as a bowl. All you need is a mature coconut and few simple tools to make your own natural coconut bowls. Coconuts are one of my most well-praised versatile fruits. Not only are there tons of ingredients and uses that you can get from a single coconut, but we can even utilize the shell for gorgeous homemade coconut bowls. They are biodegradable and compostable. They are a great alternative to single-use plastic and have a minimal impact on the planet. These bowls have an incredible impact. Not only do they save millions of coconut shells from being thrown into landfill each year, but they are also 100% natural, free of BPA, toxins, synthesis and plastics, and are super safe for you and the environment. They are reusable, biodegradable and totally natural, meaning that they won't pile up in landfill, pollute our oceans or harm our wildlife. Coconut shells are the most sustainable and eco-friendly crockeries of all. Coconut shells add a rustic, authentic look to your kitchen. Eating in them might take you back to ages. They are easy to wash and store and are low maintenance. From soups to ice cream, you can serve anything in them. They tend to have a smoothing effect every time you look at them or use them. A coconut bowl is a great apparatus for an eco-friendly, reasonable way of life. These bowls take years to wear out or go bad. You can plant samplings in them and turn them into a pot. They are 100% zero waste product.
Good morning one and all. My name is Sonakshi Gupta. Today I am going to show you how to make an eco-friendly honey face mask that is much better than the chemical based face masks.
Half cup coconut oil, 1/4 cup honey, 1/4 cup brown sugar, 1 teaspoon grounded cinnamon, half lemon juice. Coconut oil is moisturizing and has antimicrobial properties that helps to treat acne. Honey is both an antioxidant and an antibacterial and is moisturizing for the glowing skin. Brown sugar is an exfoliant for smooth and radiant skin. Cinnamon is an antibacterial that stimulates blood flow and helps to heal acne. Lemon juice is rich in vitamin C and an antioxidant that helps to clear and tighten the pores. Now let's mix it well.
This is the final product, the honey face mask. Apply and scrub it in circular motion on your face for 15 to 20 minutes and wash it thoroughly.
Our planet has become over the years a dumping ground for garbage, which has negative effects on our environment and our future generations. Around 6.3 billion tons of plastic has been generated worldwide. But the question is, can we really replace plastic with eco-friendly products? Hi, this is KV Amni, roll number 121-3200-86023, a student of BCom IPP, first year. I am here with an eco-friendly bottle that is made up of bamboo, which can totally replace plastic bottles. Also many health benefits, like it has antioxidants, it reduces blood cholesterol, it contains silica, which helps in improving the bone density. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So let's take one step forward in removing plastic away from our lives and adopting eco-friendly products. At last, I would like to thank the EVS department of St. Francis College for Women, Hyderabad, for providing me this opportunity to act and think upon this project. Thank you.
Materials used: old rice bag, old bed sheet. Eco-friendly products help preserve the environment by significantly reducing the pollution and waste they could produce. Eco-friendly products can be made from scratch or from recycled materials. This kind of product is easily recognizable. Eco-friendly products are also known as environment-friendly products or green products, as they cause minimal harm to people and environment. Recycling old materials reduces the impact of its consumption on the environment. Here I am reusing old rice bag and old bed sheet to make a tote bag.
Hi guys, this is Vishravani from BTMBC and my roll number is 121-3200-50037. I am here to explain you about bioenzymes. Basically, bioenzymes are prepared by using three different ingredients in your kitchen. And the uses of bioenzymes are, they are used as floor cleaner, glass cleaner and also used for plants. Due to this pandemic session, we are buying a lots and lots of sanitizers and house cleaners which are made by chemicals. So, I thought of doing a natural house cleaner which help you all. So let's get started.
Thank you.
information, label the container with today's date. Keep it in a dark place and away from the sunlight so that fermentation process takes place. For first 15 days, open the lid slightly and keep it away so that any sort of gases that is released during fermentation will be released out. For another 15 days, open the lid in alternative days. For next 1 to 2 months, close the lid tightly. After 1 to 2 months, strain the contents and squeeze out all the goodness out of it. The leftover pulp can be blended and used as the concentrated cleaner for tough strains. So guys, that's about the preparation of bioenzymes. Hope you all liked it and try it too. Thank you. Stay safe.
Yay, there's our hanger, which works as good as a hanger bought at store. Therefore, it's a great way to reuse plastic. See you next time. Bye.
Hello, hi, this is Elena. Today I'm going to show you the making of eco-friendly cloth bags.
morning. And thank you so much for joining us. It's been a pleasure looking at your work. Trust me, you guys were amazing. All the entries were very, very beautiful. So I would like to introduce all of you to our judge for the competition, which is Dr. Sai Bhavani ma'am from Department of Environmental Studies, Nizam College. Welcome, ma'am. Ma'am is a born environmentalist, an amazing, amazing teacher, and has written national and international papers and has published several chapters in several books. Welcome, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us today. And thank you so much for evaluating our talented youngsters.
Thank you, Ma. Thank you, Anushka, for such a wonderful introduction. I'm highly privileged to be part of your program. First of all, a very warm welcome and good morning to everyone, all the participants, and my warm greetings to the principal, vice principal, dean academics, and Dhanlakshmi ma'am, and all the participants here, and president also, Anushka. Good morning, everyone. So nowadays, our environmental issues, the problems which we are facing are at a very alarming rate because of the overpopulation, because of the degradation of the natural resources. To meet the population demands, we are slowly diverting all our resources. There is a drastic decrease in our natural resources because of this degradation problem. Deforestation, is it not? Urbanization, globalization, everything is having a negative effect on our environment. So the EcoFlare program, which is conducted by you, that is how to reuse the waste, is really a very excellent program which is conducted in this episode. So when we have judged the students, all the students have participated well and their works are really extraordinary. The maximum utilization of the waste which the students have demonstrated are excellently good, remarkably good, ma'am. So the first prize goes to Lakshmi Aishwarya for her preparation of clay Ganesha. And the second prize goes to Amani for bamboo bottle preparation. And the third prize goes to Utpuri Shravani for her preparation of bioenzymes for the cleaning purpose. And these three products are excellently good, which are really not degrading the environment and are helping the environment to a larger extent. So these three students or the participants, I declare them as the winners.
That's great.
And all the students also and who have participated have really done a very good job. As Gandhiji has said, we must become the change we want to see in our society. And I think this is very much demonstrated by the students.
Thank you so much, ma'am. We really appreciate you joining us today.
One last thing. I request everyone to please turn on their cameras for a picture and then we can exit the meeting.
Looking at to study abroad? MeetUniversity.com is here to help. We help you search, discover and apply to the right university. Our technology will help you choose the best university, find relevant information, help you prepare a successful application and put you in direct touch with the admission officers. Subscribe to our premium service and connect with our admissions expert right now to get started with your application. Bon voyage.
We would like to thank our beloved principal, Dr. Sister Sandra Horta, for her constant trust and guidance. We would like to thank the Yuvaflare event coordinator, Dr. Reena Devan ma'am, assistant coordinator, Ms. Nikita Sharma ma'am, and all the coordinators for their guidance throughout our YuvEcofreak journey. We would like to thank Dr. Sai Bhavani ma'am for lending us her expertise and evaluating our talented youngsters. We would also like to thank our club coordinator, Ms. Dhanalakshmi ma'am, for her love and guidance. We would like to thank our truly generous sponsors, Bharat Petroleum Gachibowli and Meet University. We would like to thank our technicians for their support
throughout this event. We would also like to thank all our participants for making this event a huge success. Last but not the least, we would like to thank all our viewers for gracing us with your presence at our event. Thank you.